In 1866, Franz Paul Hamberger founded the Industriewerke Hamberger in Ziegelberg. Right at the very beginning, he set up the company on several pillars, with a matchstick factory, a sawmill, and a brickyard. He created a diverse product range. What started as a modest enterprise developed into a flourishing company over the years. In June 1912, Franz Paul Hamberger died. His sons, Franz Paul II and Max Hamberger, were the ones who then set the course for the company's future. With the production of toilet seats, they established a new product range in 1912 that made the brand name HARO famous far beyond the borders of Bavaria several years later. Unfortunately, Max Hamberger already died in 1914, after which Franz Paul Hamberger II led the company as the sole managing director. In 1916, he purchased Gut Filzenhof near Ziegelberg, which provided food for the Hamburger employees, in particular during the First World War. Together with a loyal group of employees, he managed to expand the matchstick production, the brickyard, and the sawmill. Together, they survived the years of crisis during the First World War and the post-war era, and laid the foundation for the further expansion of the company. The company developed successfully, and in 1920, the third generation took over responsibility, with Franz and Max II, as well as Rudolf Hamberger, in 1923. They modernized and expanded the production of matches, bricks, and the sawmill. However, they were faced with tough challenges due to the death of Franz Paul Hamberger II in 1945 and the rebuilding of the company after the Second World War. The onset of the Wirtschaftswunder, the post-war economic miracle in Germany, led to a boom in brick production and later on of the toilet seat and match production. By entering the area of parquet and sports flooring production, expanding the toilet seat production, rebuilding the match factory, and modernizing the brickyard, Franz, Max II, and Rudolf Hamberger gave the family company important impulses during the following decades. Meanwhile, Rudolf Hamberger's sons, Peter and Rudolf Hamberger II, joined the company in the 1960s as the fourth generation. The brickyard reached a new production peak before it was destroyed by a large fire in 1968. And the matchstick production reached a record high before the abolishment of the monopoly for safety matches in 1983. As early as 1976, Peter Hamberger had seen the importance of the do-it-yourself trend and started a new line of business with HARO's own DIY stores. After the death of Max Hamberger II in 1987, it was the task of Rudolf II and Peter Hamberger alone to further expand the sawmill, the production of toilet seats, the parquet production, and the laminate floor business through new factories and international sales activities. When Dr. Peter M. Hamberger was appointed managing director in 2002, the fifth generation took over responsibility for leading the company. That meant that once again, two generations were working together in leading the company, thus guaranteeing continuity and stability for the future. Under their management, Hamberger Industriewerke GmbH is in the year of its anniversary, a company with more than 2,300 employees worldwide, and annual sales of over 300 million euros in Germany and 90 export markets. In 1866, the company's founder, Franz Paul Hamberger, would even in his wildest dreams probably never have imagined the significance his company would have gained 150 years later. What he had probably been hoping for, but could never have foreseen at that time, is what until today has remained the guarantee for the company's success. The fact that the company is still in the hands of a family whose legacy over five generations has again and again led to success by combining tradition and progress, and still does so today. It is the restless and brave who move the world, as contentment knows no progress.